Preparing to live stream the webinar. Redirecting to YouTube. And we're live.
Vivian? No, there's no sound, Vivian.
Thank you, Profe.
Muy buenas tardes. Bienvenidos a la graduación virtual de la clase de 2020 de la Asociación de Estudiantes de Derecho de la Raza. Este programa se está grabando. Felicidades a todos los graduados. Estamos tan orgullosos de ustedes. Mi nombre es Catalina Lozano y yo soy una profesora en la Universidad de California, Hastings College of the Law. También soy la consejera para la raza. Yo sé que todos nosotros quisiéramos celebrar esta graduación como siempre, con comida, música, familia y baile, como hacemos. Pero desafortunadamente, como ustedes saben, esta pandemia ha cambiado todo y por eso nuestra graduación normal no es posible. Pero algunos de nosotros no íbamos a permitir pasar esta ocasión tan significante sin reconocimiento y celebración de sus logros tremendos. Primero, quisiera dar crédito y gracias a las dos mujeres increíbles que trabajan sin descanso conmigo para este evento, María Domínguez y Vivian Sandoval. Entre muchas otras cosas, estas mujeres recaudaron dinero y pasaron horas interminables trabajando con varias plataformas virtuales. Vivian fue responsable de obtener las estolas y gorros de ustedes. Y María es la razón por la que tenemos nuestra oradora principal, la honorable Yvonne González Rogers. Yo estoy muy agradecida por la ayuda de María y Vivian. También damos gracias a todas las personas que han donado dinero para comprar las estolas y gorros de ustedes. Sus nombres están en el programa con los mensajes que escribieron para ustedes. Léanlos para que sepan que ustedes son amados y apreciados. Esta graduación no sería posible sin la ayuda y el apoyo de la gente fantástica de Hastings: Grace Hum, Camilla Tubbs, Lauren Lofton, Emily Hahn, Laura Irvine y Vishal Lalchand. Ellos respondieron rápidamente cuando solicitamos ayuda. Gracias a todos. Y ahora en inglés. Good afternoon, and welcome to the first ever, and we hope the last, UC Hastings La Raza virtual graduation for the class of 2020. Congratulations to all the graduates. We are so very proud of you. My name is Catalina Lozano. I am an adjunct professor of law at UC Hastings, and I am also the faculty advisor to the La Raza Law Students Association. I know that all of us would have preferred to celebrate this graduation with food, music, family, and dancing, as we always do. But unfortunately, as you know, the pandemic has changed everything, so that is not possible. But some of us were not going to allow this momentous occasion to go without acknowledgement and celebration of your tremendous accomplishments. First, I would like to acknowledge and give credit to the two incredible women who worked tirelessly on this event with me: Maria Dominguez, class of 2013, and Vivian Sandoval, class of 2019. These ladies are dynamos. Among many other things, they raised funds and spent endless hours working with and troubleshooting the various virtual platforms. Vivian was responsible for obtaining your stoles and caps. And Maria is the reason that we have our fabulous keynote speaker, the Honorable Yvonne González Rogers. I am very grateful for all of Maria's and Vivian's help. We also thank everyone who donated money to purchase your stoles and your caps. Their names are on the program with the message that they wrote to you. Please read them so that you know that you are loved and appreciated. This graduation would not be possible without the help and the support of all the terrific people at Hastings. Grace Hum, Camilla Tubbs, Lauren Lofton, Emily Hahn, Seema Ohadi, Laura Irvine, and Vishal Lalchand. They responded quickly when we asked them for help, and we thank them all. And now it is my pleasure to present Maria Dominguez, who will introduce our keynote speaker. Y ahora es mi gran placer presentar María Domínguez, que van a presentar a nuestra oradora principal. María.
Gracias, profesora Lozano. Buenas tardes a todos. Es mi gran privilegio introducir a nuestra oradora principal, la honorable Yvonne González Rogers. La jueza Yvonne González Rogers nació en Houston, Texas, y se crió en San Antonio. Se graduó con honores cum laude de la Universidad de Princeton en 1987 y recibió su título de doctor en jurisprudencia de la Universidad de Texas, Austin, en 1991. Y completó su último año en la Universidad de California, Berkeley School of Law. La jueza González Rogers trabajó durante muchos años en el despacho de abogados Cooley LLP en San Francisco antes de que el gobernador Arnold Schwarzenegger la nombrara en 2008 para el Tribunal Superior del Condado de Alameda. Y 3 años más tarde, el presidente Barack Obama nombró a la jueza González Rogers para servir como jueza de la Corte Federal de Distrito para el Distrito Norte de California. Ella es la primera latina en ocupar ese oficio. Y fue un honor para mí atender su ceremonia de inducción, donde tomó su juramento cuando yo todavía era un estudiante de derecho. Y ahora en inglés. Good afternoon, everyone. It is my privilege to introduce our keynote speaker, the Honorable Yvonne González Rogers. Judge Yvonne González Rogers was born in Houston, Texas, and raised in San Antonio. She graduated cum laude from Princeton University in 1987 and received her Juris Doctor from the University of Texas, Austin in 1991. She completed her final year at the University of California, Berkeley School of Law. Judge González Rogers worked for many years at Cooley LLP in San Francisco, before Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger appointed her in 2008 to the Alameda County Superior Court. 3 years later, President Barack Obama appointed Judge González Rogers to serve as a federal district court judge for the Northern District of California. She is the first Latina to occupy that role. She currently chairs the Northern District's committee charged with administering the Criminal Justice Act as it relates to indigent defense, and has also sat by designation on the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals. In addition to her judicial duties, Judge González Rogers served on the Board of Trustees for Princeton University from 2014 to 2018, and currently serves as a board member of the Northern District Chapter of the Association of Business Trial Lawyers, and on the Advisory Council for the Law Academy based in Oakland, California. On a personal note, it was a great honor to attend Judge González Rogers' induction ceremony when I was just a 2L student. Y ahora, por favor, démosle una cálida bienvenida a nuestra oradora principal, la jueza Yvonne González Rogers. And now, please join me in giving a warm welcome to our keynote speaker, Judge Yvonne González Rogers. Woo!
Good afternoon, everyone. Before I get started, I heard Professor Lozano identify all of the individuals who worked so incredibly hard to put this virtual graduation together. I didn't hear her thank herself. I think we need to thank her as well. But I would like you all to unmute yourself and let's actually give them a round of applause. I mean, this is incredible what they have done. I know Latinos like to party and they know how to cheer. So I was trying to see the gallery view because I actually want to see you, not myself. That's important. Because as I was reflecting on all that you have accomplished and this historic pandemic, which has put us in such an odd place, it occurred to me that it was incumbent on me to try to figure out how to bring these worlds together in some kind of positive way, because what you have all accomplished is so amazing. I am an optimist. You should know that. And so I kept having this recurring thought, which I'll get to, but it didn't fully crystallize until a few days ago when we did our dress rehearsal. And then last night, when I read all of your biographical statements and your aspirations, and then it hit me. I heard Professor Lozano refer to you as doctors, and many of you refer to yourself as law graduates, and all of that's true. But my concept is a little different. I want to leave you with another designation, another lens from which to view yourselves, another model. A model that I hope will stay with you over the next few days, months, maybe even years. Because in my mind, you were not just law graduates or juris doctors in this historic time of a pandemic. You are legal champions. That's how I think of you, as champions. Look up that word. It has so many nuances and so aptly describes each and every one of you. You are entering our legal community, which is now in what I would call a battle state. These are not normal times. If they were, we would not be here virtually. Affliction abounds. Rights are restricted, challenges confront members of our community, our state, and our nation. Now more than ever, the law matters, justice matters, and you are now here to help fight the fight, to bring reason and rationality, logic and compassion into the conversation and into the courtrooms, to be the voice for those who are mute. During times of strife, I worry. I worry about those in our community who shrivel in the face of adversity. But then I think of you. And I see all your faces and I read all your aspirations and I don't worry. I have hope. I see light. Why? Because I know that you and we, all of us here, our families who are listening and watching, were not born and raised in a life of luxury. You, we, all of us, we came from humble beginnings. Many of you are firsts. You and I know what it is like to climb mountains, to swim upstream, to forge rivers. You have diligence and perseverance and persistence. The fact that you are here today proves that you have prevailed. So the future. The reality is, none of us really know what the future will hold. It has curves. Life has all sorts of things in store for us. And we don't know what it is. But I tell you, it is a fabulous adventure. You know, even Dr. Seuss says in that historic graduation book that many of you may have seen out there, things can happen and frequently do to people as brainy and footsie as you. And it's true. My path was not straight. It went forwards and backwards. It went up and down valleys and mountains. It certainly wasn't destined. A United States federal judge? Me? I don't think so. My parents only spoke Spanish until they went to grade school. Each, the eldest of nine, grew up in houses that only had two or three rooms. Some of you have maybe have heard me tell the story of my mother, who thought the English word for the word bathroom was bescused. Because when she went to school, you had to ask to be excused to go to the bathroom. Every New Year's Eve, my father would eat tortillas and salsita to remind him of the days growing up when that was all he had to eat. My mother didn't go to college. My father did on the GI Bill. He was the only one in his family of nine who did. For my parents, education was important. It was the path to a new life. And they sacrificed to send the five of us, my sisters and brother, to Catholic school. And my mom sacrificed even more to send me to Princeton. Growing up, my father repeatedly told me, "Mija, God put you on this earth to help people." I believe him. The nuns, over the course of 13 years of Catholic school, instilled in me, at my core, a commitment to serve. And coincidentally, at Princeton, where I grew up intellectually, its unofficial motto was "In the Nation's Service." And our own Justice Sonia Sotomayor expanded that to be in the nation's service and the service of all humanity. It is a motto which I hold close to my heart. It would have been impossible to predict my path given my family's limited view. They didn't know that their daughter would become the first Latina partner in a law firm with hundreds of lawyers. We didn't even know that kind of thing existed. I didn't even know that law firms had more than five people until OCI, on-campus recruiting as a second-year law student. None of us knew that when I testified in divorce court as a child, that one day I would be a judge. It never entered our minds because it wasn't part of our worldview. Even, I have to tell you, even as a lawyer and as the chair of the Judiciary Committee for our local, state, and national La Raza Lawyers Associations, it never occurred to me that I would be a federal judge. How could it? It would take a miracle, and yet here I am. I must admit that while my worldview was narrow, no one ever told me that I couldn't do something. Well, I did want to be a priest, and they told me I couldn't be a priest. But look at me now, I'm wearing a black robe, I can marry people. It kind of worked out. So what I want to encourage you to do is expand your worldview. Open the doors, take a risk, dream big. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. You don't have to be perfect, but you do have to work hard and create opportunities. Don't wait for them. Be innovative, be creative. This model of self-confidence and unavailing spirit is proven. It's fundamental to the best of humanity. 2,300 years ago, Plato wrote. 2,300 years ago, he wrote. Have you noticed that a high spirit is invincible and unbeatable? Its presence makes the whole soul fearless and unconquerable. Well, I've noticed it, and I see it in you. I know that you know your life is not easy, and yet you have the fire in your soul to forge a path which will bring honor to our profession and justice to those you serve. So, UC Hastings La Raza 2020 class of legal champions. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Well, first, party. Definitely party, celebrate, cheer each other on. As Professor Lozano said, food, music, dancing. I'm sure all of you will do that with your families and friends. But then, sometime soon, I want you to find a quiet place and reflect not only on this vista, but on the mountains you want to climb and the battles you want to fight. And remember, being a champion for others, especially those in need, makes for a purposeful life. A life filled with such a purpose is a life well lived. Congratulations.
Gracias, Judge Gonzalez Rogers. Thank you. Ahora es mi honor y mi placer presentar a ustedes los graduados de la clase de 2020. Sobre la nominación de los alumnos de la raza de la Universidad de California, Hastings College of the Law, hoy otorgamos sobre cada uno de ustedes el título de doctor en jurisprudencia con todos los derechos y privilegios que corresponden. And now in English. And now it is my honor and my pleasure to present to you the graduates of the class of 2020. Upon the nomination of the La Raza alumni of UC Hastings College of the Law, we now confer upon each one of you the degree of Juris Doctor with all of the rights and the privileges pertaining thereto. Victoria Maria Aguiñaga Ruiz.
Gracias, gracias a todos. Thank you everyone. I just want to thank all of my family and my friends for tuning in. I'm Victoria, and when I started as a student at UC Hastings, my Nino Danny had just passed away, and I moved back home to be close to my family. And I'm wearing his t-shirt that he tie-dyed with me and my grandma today. And the only reason that I'm here is because my mom, my grandma, taught me that you can do something that you have no idea how to do. My grandma taught me how to ride a bike. She's never ridden a bike. My grandma would look at my mom's homework and erase the letters when they were messy. My grandma was a farm worker and didn't know how to read or write, but she somehow knew what to erase and what to keep. My mom one time saw my messy writing and she cried. And I thought that she was crying because my grandma didn't erase mine like she erased hers, and she thought that was unfair. But I think she cried because she realized she was gonna face new trials, new having to show me how to write in the way that people can read, and she did it. It is only with my family and my friends that I get to be here right now. And that if I pass the bar, I will get to keep a job that I have as a public defender. It's the only reason I came to law school. because Black people and brown people are locked up, and those are our family members. And so this piece of paper is a tool, just like my grandma's eraser, just like my mom's deep tears and joy and happiness, they're tools. We use them to fight the battle and to win the war. That is our freedom. That is justice. That is our liberation. So thank you, Jamie, Joey, Alex, Kenya, Doug, Lupita, Rosie, Lori. This is a tape my grandma made in English and Spanish. And this is a bobblehead from the Giants, our only family antique. And I am Victoria from San Jose, California, Juris Doctorate. Victoria Maria Ruiz Aguinaga, Juris Doctorate. Thank you, Adrian. All my friends, Tess, everyone, thank you. Courtney, Juan, Sandeep, everyone, thank you.
Ileana Juriz Aranda.
Hola a todos, les quiero dar gracias por estar aquí con todos nosotros. Siempre he dicho que siempre quise ser abogada y aquí estoy un paso más cerca de ese objetivo y sé que esto no fue posible sin mi familia. Les quiero dar gracias a mi familia, especialmente a mis papás, por siempre apoyarme en todo en mi carrera, por sus sacrificios y su motivación, que por ustedes lo logre, que por este diploma es tan mío como lo es de ustedes, y los amo tanto. Y gracias a mis amigos y a mi pareja por estar a mi lado en las buenas y en las malas. Y gracias por aguantarme durante todo este proceso, porque sé que no habría sido capaz de todo esto sin su amor y apoyo. Y ahora soy Ileana Judith Aranda, doctorado en Derecho de Leyes. I am now Ileana Judith Aranda, Juris Doctorate.
¡Bravo! María Alejandra Avalos Cruz.
Thank you to everyone that helped put this virtual graduation together. It has been a long and difficult journey to get here, but we all have made it. All of us here add change in the legal community. Our hard work and effort will change the diversity in the legal field. Now, all the effort we put in law school was not without friends, mentors, and our family. I am sure I am not alone when I say that this victory and accomplishment is also for my family. I want to especially acknowledge my mother. Mi madre es una mujer ejemplar que me ha enseñado a luchar. Desde que nos fuimos de El Salvador, ella no ha dejado de trabajar para que yo y mis hermanos podamos cumplir todas nuestras sueños y metas. Ella no podía ayudarme con la tarea de la escuela, pero ella me ayudó con algo más importante, ser una mujer fuerte y independiente. Soy la primera en graduarme de la universidad y pronto seré la primera abogada en la familia. Gracias, papá. Es por todo su esfuerzo que he logrado lo que he logrado ahora. I would also like to thank all of you for being there. Whether it was indirectly, you all have motivated me to continue with your hard work, especially my Latinas Girl Squad. You guys have helped me get through my struggles throughout law school and made me overcome my feelings of not belonging. You have calmed me down when I've gotten stressed and celebrated my achievements with me. I am grateful I have met all of you and created a forever community. I am excited to see all of you in the future, and we can reminisce and laugh on how we celebrated graduation virtually. Lastly, I would like to thank myself for never giving up and pushing through the tears and the stress. I am now proud to say that I am Maria Avalos Cruz, Juris Doctor.
Maria. Tanya Gabriela Bonilla.
Gracias a todas las personas que tuvieron parte a tratar de hacer todo esto. Primeramente, le quiero dar gracias a Dios que me ha ayudado cada día con oraciones. Seguramente le quiero pedir gracias a mi familia, especialmente a mi mamá que ha sacrificado mucho tiempo y su cuerpo durante el trabajo cada día para que esté aquí. La amo mucho y es por ella que estoy aquí y soy muy orgullosa de ser hija de Imelda Maya y Oscar Bonilla, que trataron su vida para que esté aquí, y solo espero y quiero hacerlos muy proud of me, y las amo. Soy Tania Gabriela Bonilla, and I'm a Juris Doctor.
Carlin Duraney.
Hello everyone, my name is Carlin Duraney. Unfortunately, my parents didn't teach me how to speak Spanish, so this speech is gonna be in English. But on a side note, Rosetta Stone is free for 3 months, so everyone hop on that with the time you have off. Anyways, I wanna thank everyone who helped me along the way for law school, especially because I moved across the country from Florida and I didn't know too many people in California. But I'm thankful that I found a community and a family within UC Hastings to help me get through this difficult time. And we all had our ups and our downs. And I'm thankful that we were all there to help each other. Even if it just came to motivating someone, we were always there for each other. And I'm grateful for that. I am now Carlin Duraney, Juris Doctor.
Carlin!
I do represent.
Woo. Kenny Gutierrez Ochoa.
Buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Kenny Gutierrez Ochoa. Le dedico mi diploma a mis padres porque este logro también es de ellos. Desde que era niño, mi papá me llamaba su licenciado. Fue un título que abracé con honor. Aunque no sabía exactamente qué hacía un abogado, sabía que protegían a las personas. Entonces, desde mi infancia, supe que quería ser abogado. Y hoy estoy un paso de cumplir mi sueño. Mi camino a la escuela de leyes ha estado lleno de mucha lucha. Pero afortunadamente, ha tenido una familia amorosa y solidaria que me ha ayudado. Me gustaría agradecerlos individually. Primero, gracias a mis padres por todos los sacrificios que hicieron para que yo pudiera recibir una educación. A mi papá, gracias por creer siempre en mí y enseñarme ética, valores y liderazgo en el trabajo duro. Mi papá me dijo, si no quieres trabajar como un burro como nosotros, agarra tu educación. A mi mamá, gracias por su amor incondicional, su fe y apoyo. Nunca me diste por vencido y me has empujado a ser una mejor persona. Gracias por llamarme todos los días para ver cómo estoy, si ha comido, si estoy bien, y por recordarme que no tomar pasos para atrás, pero para adelante. A mi hermana Carmen, gracias por ayudarme durante los momentos más difíciles de mi vida y por todo lo que haces por nuestra familia. A mi hermana Berta, gracias. Gracias por llevarme a la clínica cuando estaba enfermo, llevarme por donde quiera cuando éramos jóvenes y por ser una latina orgullosa y por tu apoyo y amor. A mi hermano Javier, gracias por dejarme vivir en tu casa cuando la vida era muy difícil para mí, ayudarme a encontrar trabajo y por tu apoyo y amor incondicional. Y a mi hermano Rafael, gracias por ser un hermano mayor, ayudarme cuando te llamo, por tu sentido del humor y por tu apoyo y amor. A mi hermana Griselda, que ya no está con nosotros, gracias por liderar el camino en nuestra familia para la educación, enseñarme a servir a la comunidad y ayudarme a cambiar mi vida. Cuando éramos niños, acordamos comenzar un bufete de abogados juntos. Esta diploma también está dedicada a ti. Y a mi novia Margarita, gracias por tu amor incondicional y apoyo. Toma un pueblo entero para terminar la carrera académica, pero hoy puedo decir con gran orgullo que tengo éxito. Gracias a Dios por siempre darme fortaleza. Estoy muy agradecido con mi familia, maestros, mis hermanos, mis amigos y amigas y todas las personas maravillosas que conocí en el camino. Gracias a la raza de UC Hastings, profesores, mentores, alumnos y mi familia. Y como dice mi mamá, adelante y adelante vamos, pero juntos. I am now Kenny Gutierrez, Juris Doctor.
Wendy Melissa Hernandez.
Buenas tardes, and thank you all for joining us today. Everyone near and far in LA, in the Bay, la familia in Mississippi, in Honduras. I especially want to thank District Judge Maria Ivonne Gonzalez Rogers, Maria Dominguez, Vivian Sandoval, and Professora Catalina Lozano. Without your selfless, powerful leadership, we would not be celebrating the Hastings La Raza Class of 2020 online today. Thank you for raising our spirits and ensuring we commemorate this milestone en comunidad y en familia. My peers and I attained our legal education during a unique but very telling era. We entered law school on the heels of the 45th presidential election and have been training diligently despite witnessing one of the most painful Supreme Court confirmation hearings, especially as women. We excelled in and led externships, student orgs, clinics, moot court teams, law journals, even as California was literally on fire and amidst power outages. Despite all of this, we never lost sight of the importance to always look back and lend a helping hand to those behind us, just like those ahead of us in the pipeline always did. Juntos nos aplicamos y nos hicimos abogados. Y yo sé que seguiremos batallando por nuestras comunidades. Special shout out to my two younger siblings who also earned their bachelor's degree this spring. My mother, Celia Hernandez, for raising us three on her own and who also earned her US citizenship this past March. And last but definitely not least, thank you to all of my law school professors, mentors, friends, my in-laws, my LTA sisters, and to the following bar associations who funded my degree. The Latina Lawyers Bar Association, the California Change Lawyers Association, the Bar Association of San Francisco's Justice and Diversity Center, the Zichron Family Foundation, the Santa Clara La Raza Lawyers Association, the East Bay La Raza Lawyers Association, the Mexican American Bar Association, and the Mexican American Legal Defense Education Fund. Without your support, I would not be where I am. I am now Wendy Melissa Hernandez, Doctora de Derechos de Leyes. I am now Wendy Melissa Hernandez, Juris Doctor.
Honduras. Jessica Lizeth Herrera.
Mi mamá siempre me dice que primero le tengo que dar las gracias a Dios, porque sin Dios yo sé que nada es posible. Segundo, quiero agradecerte a ti, mamá, por todos los sacrificios que has hecho por mí. Quiero que sepas que eres la persona más fuerte que conozco. Tú me criaste sola, sin la ayuda de nadie, sin esposo, sin padres, sin hermanos, sin primos, sin nadie. Y siento que eres, yo sé que fue tan difícil, pero siempre me demostraste que con la voluntad de Dios y con gran determinación puedes seguir adelante. Tu fuerza me sirvió como un ejemplo y desde niña me prometí a mí misma que un día yo te iba a comprar una casa y te iba a llevar a vacaciones conmigo, porque eso es lo que tú te mereces por trabajar dos trabajos pesados para darme un techo. También quiero que sepas que soy muy orgullosa de ser tu hija y que no me da pena tener una mamá que no habla inglés. Nunca me ha dado pena que trabajes en limpieza porque yo sé que ese trabajo es duro y ningún estudio mío se compara con los sacrificios que tú has hecho para que yo tenga oportunidades que tú nunca tuviste. Gracias por todo, ma. También le quiero dar las gracias a mi hermana, Jennifer. You have been like a second parent to me. Thank you for sacrificing your adolescence to help raise me. I will never forget you working after school at Quiznos to help pay for my clarinet band read. I will never forget you giving up your freedom to pick me up from band practice every day and using your money to take me out to the movies and paying for my dual credit high school classes that allowed me to graduate high school with 2 years of college credit. I want you to know that you have been my biggest cheerleader throughout my life. In all my self-doubt growing up dyslexic, you were the first to always brag about any small academic achievement I made, and you praised me so much that I slowly began to think that maybe I was smart. Thank you for always believing in me and making me feel like the sky was my limit. And lastly, I want to thank my sorority big, Maria Alonso, for being my mentor in all law school things. I am now Jessica Herrera, Juris Doctorate.
Woo! Woo! Oh. Cindy Vanessa Muro.
Buenas tardes todos. Estoy llena de emoción. Y aunque no pude tener la graduación que siempre me imaginé, estoy agradecida por la graduación de hoy. Eso es porque puedo compartir este logro con mis seres queridos en los Estados Unidos y en México. Este logro es de todos nosotros. Yo no estuviera aquí sin su apoyo y su amor. Especialmente mis padres, hermanos y pareja. Gracias por creer en mí cuando yo misma me dudaba. Gracias por limpiar mis lágrimas cuando parecía que todo fallaba. Gracias por su apoyo incondicional. Los quiero mucho. As a Latina, first generation college graduate, becoming a Juris Doctor means defying odds. When I began law school, I felt alone and overwhelmed. But La Raza, it became my home. It became my family, especially las mujeres de La Raza. We experienced our successes together. And also our failures. We cried and we laughed, and what once felt like decades to end now feels like it ended in the blink of an eye. We are graduating. I'm so proud of all of us. We did it. I am now Cindy Vanessa Muro, Juris Doctor.
Yay, Cindy! Woo!
We are Mexico.
Oscar Eduardo Peralta.
Hi, everyone. I will keep my comments brief. I want to say thank you to those who organized today's graduation. I want to thank my entire La Raza family, and I will miss you all. I hope that we can see each other soon in person, and I can't wait to celebrate together in future as attorneys. I also want to thank my partner, Manuel, for dealing me for the past 3 years, and he has always been my rock every single moment. And to Fabiola, who's listening, my ride or die since college, I want to say this will literally be you in 2 years, and I can't wait for that. Thank you, everyone. I am now Oscar Peralta, Juris Doctor.
Yay! Yay!
Oscar. Irvin Reyes.
Hello, everybody. First, I would like to thank the entire La Raza group, Professora Lozano, Maria, Vivian, and everyone who helped make this event happen. It means a lot to me and my family. As you can see, I have a lot of support. Everybody's here. Shout out to the entire family. The next part is for my family. Le quiero dar gracias a toda mi familia por la ayuda y el apoyo que me han dado los últimos 3 años. Le quiero dar gracias a mi mamá, quien siempre me ha apoyado y quien siempre me motivó a hacer más de lo necesario. Le quiero dar gracias a mi papá, quien siempre me entrenó a soñar grande y quien me enseñó cómo ser fuerte mentalmente. Le quiero dar gracias a mi hermano, who stepped up and took care of many of my financial responsibilities while I was away at Hastings. Le quiero dar gracias a mi tío Joel, el troquero que me llevaba la comida que mi mamá me mandaba cuando tenía hambre. Le quiero dar gracias a mi tía Juana, mi mamá Gloria, mi papá Emilio, mamá Kailita, my mentors, y todos los que me apoyaron en este viaje. Yo estudié y trabajé no solo para mí, sino que también para toda mi familia. Sin ellos no hubiera sido posible. Gracias por todo. Los quiero y los aprecio mucho. Y ahora les presento el licenciado Irving Reyes.
¡Bravo, mijo!
¡Bravo!
¿Dónde está Pedrito?
He's in the back, but I'll bring him later.
Felicidades.
Elizabeth May Silva.
Briefly, I want to thank the graduation committee for all of your time and effort in putting it together this virtual graduation. Seeing how you put together this ceremony demonstrates again the support that the RESA community has given. Most importantly, I would like to thank my family for supporting me throughout all my life, on my academic career, and especially during my time in law school. My family taught me the value of an education, which is something that I carried with me throughout all of my academic career, and I'll carry with me into my professional career. While I generally loved and enjoyed my time at Hastings, it wasn't always fun. Law school was challenging. There were times when it was really stressful. I want to thank my family for helping to keep me sane during those times, especially during 1L, when it seemed like all everyone wanted to talk about was law school. So it was really nice to be able to come home and have dinner and just talk about honestly anything that wasn't related to law. I especially want to thank my family for all their support that they gave me during my time, whether it was words of encouragement, something to eat, picking me up or dropping me off from school, or honestly leaving me alone just so I could study. I know that at times I wasn't the most pleasant person to be around and I often had a crazy schedule. So thank you for putting up with me. I couldn't have done it without you. I love you. I am now Elizabeth May Silva, Juris Doctor.
Laura Tovar.
Hello, everyone. First and foremost, I would like to thank the graduation committee for making this happen. It's very special to celebrate with you all, and especially for those that would not have been able to make the actual graduation on a Monday. But thank you for being here today. Le quiero dar las gracias a mi familia. Ya me conocen de chillona, pero gracias por siempre apoyarme. Y aguantarme cuando en veces no les pude regresar la llamada o visitar casa, pero aquí estamos hoy, lo hice, lo hicimos, esto es para ustedes. I also wanted to give a shout out to La Raza, generally all of you, as well as my Latina group. You guys know who you are. You guys are very special to me. Thank you for putting up with me, especially knowing that I'm a person that needs affirmation. You guys really got me through this. I wanted to make some specific shout outs to a couple of folks that really got me through law school. Jessica, you've heard of the story before, but thank you for talking me into staying in law school after I wanted to pack my bags during orientation. I didn't think I could do it and you talked me out of it. It was really great. Irvin, 1L year, me and you studied for every single final together and we killed it. You will always be my study buddy. Cindy, thank you for talking me out of not canceling my OCI interview because of my imposter syndrome. And my HNBA team, special place in my heart, will always be Trailblazers and I will always cherish our time in Albuquerque. And to also my partner, Sal, for putting up with me for the last 5 years through the LSAT process, the applications, we finally made it. You just have to get me through the bar. But thank you all. I am now Laura Tovar, Juris Doctor.
All right.
Latina squad.
William Tran.
Yo, mama, we made it. Just want to thank everybody for hosting this. So just want to start off with thankful for LaRaza allowing me to be in this space. You know, I'm going to point the elephant in the room. You know, I'm the only Asian in the crew. And this past 3 years been wonderful. Just working with them, venting with them, going through everything with them. Like to thank my parents, especially my dad, who's finally able to go to one of my graduations. My mom, who's always been there. And my little brother, who doesn't know anything about law school and is able to sit there and still listen to me talk to him about everything and just like nodding his head. That's all I need. He's been the real MVP in this whole thing. Thank you, and I hope we move forward. I'm now William Tran, Juris Doctor.
Veronica Zamago.
Hola a todos, gracias por estar aquí con nosotros ahora en un día muy especial. Primero le quiero dar gracias a mis padres, mi mamá María Zamago y mi papá Martín Zamago por todo su apoyo. Como dijeron una de las muchachas que las aguantaron, o sea, así me siento yo también. Segundo, le quiero dar gracias a mis tíos y mis tías que me mandaban comida, me mandaban birria hasta San Francisco, mis primas y mis primos que me han dado vivienda cuando estaba estudiando por el LSAT, mis abuelitas y mi abuelito que está en el cielo. Le quiero dar gracias a mis latinas y también a mis latinos por todo el apoyo también que nos han dado entre law school, que estudiamos juntas. And I'd also like to thank my professors at CSUB, who one, helped me transfer to UCSB and also apply to law school. They aided me with, or provided me with recommendation letters. And without them, I really don't think I would have been able to go through the process as smoothly as I did. And I'd also like to give a little shout out to my white boy, Justin. We call it LEOP Love because I met him in the LEOP program. And then, so my name, I am now Veronica Zamago, Juris Doctor.
Felicidades. Deborah Tatiana Zepeda.
Hello. First, I want to start by thanking all my family and friends who are tuning in today. I'm really happy you are joining me during this very special moment. All of you have played a role in getting me here, whether it was those check-in calls, optimistic texts, magical hugs, or just those positive vibes in my life. Thank you. I also want to give a special thank you to my brothers, Hector and Alan. Though you are my little brothers, you have been my big brothers on various occasions. You two took care of me, protected me, and made me feel safe when I needed it. You two have always accepted me for who I am and loved me unconditionally. That means the world to me. I love you guys so much. I also want to highlight a little being in my life who makes all the difference, my doggy Mia. She came into my life when I was going through a difficult loss. Not only did she mend my heart back together, she got me through it and made me a better human in the process. This little soul who is selfless, kind, and full of affection has shown me the definition of true love. Her and I are inseparable. We eat together, we go on adventures together, we cuddle together, we laugh together, and sometimes we even cry together. She makes sure I'm never alone. And many people say that I rescued her, but in reality, she rescued me. I could not have done this without her. I also want to thank my wonderful partner, Carmen. Mujer, you are so out of my league. I seriously hope that blindfold never comes off. You're beautiful, you're brilliant, caring, and extremely supportive. I know I may be a little difficult at times, but you respond with patience and charm, and somehow always manage to end up putting me back in my place. Thank you for making me feel special every single day. Te quiero mucho. También quiero agradecerles a todos mis compañeros que me ayudaron, apoyaron en esta meta. Muchos de nosotros compartimos historias similares y por eso tenemos un lazo muy especial. Lo más bonito de esta experiencia fue conocer a personas lindas. Tocaron mi corazón en modos que nunca imaginé. Estoy muy orgullosa de lo que hemos logrado. I am now Debra Tatiana Cepeda, Juris Doctor.
¡Genial!
Ahora les presento a ustedes la clase de 2020. And now I present to you the class of 2020.
¡Bravo! ¡Felicidades!
Y ahora tenemos algunas palabras finales de parte de Vivian Sandoval. And now, some final words from Vivian Sandoval.
Felicidades, graduados. Congrats, grads. Soy Vivian Sandoval, clase de 2019. I'm Vivian Sandoval, class of 2019. Quiero decir unas palabras para terminar. Y también quiero hacer un brindis para a los graduados. Por favor, tengan listos sus vasos o copas de agua, jugo, vino, soda, champán, lo que sea. Y preparen sus cámaras para tomar fotos después de esto. I would like to say a few words, and at the end, I would like to propose a toast. So please get your water, juice, soda, wine, champagne, or whatever you like to drink ready, and prepare your cameras for photos after this. A los graduados, sé que hace solo unos meses no podrían imaginar que así iban a terminar los últimos 3 años largos y exigentes de sus vidas como estudiantes. Estos tiempos son difíciles e inciertos, pero recuerden que antes de empezar a estudiar derechos, se esforzaron mucho por todo lo que deseaban y lo volvieron a hacer durante los estudios de derechos. Nunca lo olviden. Ahora tienen sus títulos que representan un nivel de preparación que muchos de ustedes comparten con solo 4% de abogados, que son los latinos. Superaron muchas barreras y eso no es algo pequeño. Es una meta que lograron, aunque eran tiempos difíciles. Y en el futuro podrán recordar esos tiempos con mucho orgullo. El mundo necesita que sean los mejores abogados. Los necesitan a ustedes. To the graduates, I know just a few months ago, this is not how you imagine closing out the last 3 long, demanding years of your life as a law student. These are difficult and uncertain times. But remember that before you started law school, you worked hard for everything you had, and you did so again during law school. Don't ever forget that. You now have a degree that represents an education you share with attorneys, where only 4% are represented as Latinos. You overcame many barriers, and this is no small feat. It's a goal you accomplished, even during these difficult times. In the future, you'll look back at this time period with pride. The world needs you to be the best lawyer you can be. It needs you. Así que, de parte de todos sus admiradores, estamos orgullosas de ustedes. So, on behalf of all your fans, we are so proud of you. And now, graduates, please change your view to gallery and join me in a toast. Salud. Say it with me.
Salud.
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 Salud. Salud. Salud.
Salud. Salud.
Salud. Centro. Y para dentro. Now, let us close with a reflection on your journey over the last 3 years.